get here early in the morning and maybe take pictures, because it is something special here.
The water is like glass until 700 swimmers get in here.
The best place to swim in southern Ontario. I don't believe that there is any place better than this.
Just as the sun starts to come up at about 5:30, Carm and Bob Nucky, our two legends, are up at 5:30, 5:45 in the morning, open the gate, and they're the welcome crew. And there's a whole population of people who never see this quarry past 8 o'clock in the morning. They come, they have their great swim, their great paddle, and then they head off to work or to back home to take care of the kids or whatever else goes on. And then the next population come in, the swim teams start to come in, and fantastic swim teams from the region. And the best thing that ever happened to C3, quite honestly, it sounds bizarre, is COVID, because as pools were closed, swim teams took up, hey, you know, maybe we'll go check out that quarry. And when they got here, they realized this is a way better place to spend a summer than a chlorinated, kind of hot, stinky pool. And so this became a great place and is a great place for swim team after swim team. So it's great to have all of these young kids doing all their beautiful swim strokes right out in front of us. And then as noon comes, people who come at lunch hour to get their swim in. Then swim lessons. Allison's done a brilliant job with swim lessons with young kids who are coming, and mom gets to sit with a cup of coffee or dad gets to sit with a book up by the car, and the kids get a great swim lesson. So the swim lessons have been very, very popular. The ability to get onto a paddleboard and just go around. We have 5 kilometers, if you follow the circumference of this incredible quarry. We have perfect drinking water. It's spring fed. It's fantastic. It stays about 21, 22 degrees Celsius all summer long. And so we have the best of all worlds. It's big enough that you can enjoy it. It's small enough that we can control it and be safe. We've got, you know, a great culture now of these families that come, they pick up their garbage, they're watching out for each other's kids. The paddleboarders get out there and enjoy their stuff. And so it's lovely for me to see my wife, who loved paddleboarding, create a paddleboard yoga class. Karen was a yoga teacher who loved to paddleboard. And so here's this beautiful water. And so people come out 3 or 4 times a week, not just to paddleboard, but some cases to paddleboard and have yoga as well. McGill, our phenomenal swim coach, all of our athletes have improved. The coaches have improved just because of being in the ambience of McGill and his brilliance. Parents are sending me emails saying, this is spectacular. We don't have to drive, you know, all the way up to Collingwood or to Wasaga Beach. We have this beautiful thing right, you know, in the middle of Caledon. And inside this location are world-class athletes. It's not just the recreational moms and dads and kids swim lessons. We literally have had people who've gone to the Sydney Olympics and won gold medals.
For Canada!
The Tokyo Olympic Games. And so, you know, high performance can live here and inspire kids from the time the sun comes up until the sun goes down. Somebody's enjoying this wonderful beach and quarry in their own way. And that is just such a community jewel. And C3 is just blessed to, you know, be the caretaker of this wonderful facility. But we realize how lucky we are to be here.